Sommelier from Home, PB3 here with a sponsored episode, Old Style. That's right, Old Style, an old Chicago favorite. Followers of the channel know that I've been experimenting recently with a very bitter Chicago product that will go unnamed, rhymes with galort. And so other Chicago companies have started to take notice, and Old Style reached out wanting to do a little partnership with us on an episode, and I was delighted. And I have a surprise in store for you, because this isn't just a sponsored episode with a beverage. I also have a culinary treat I'll be pulling in just a little bit later on. Let's take a look at the can here. Oh, they got Heilmann's right there, which nobody says in Chicago. They just call it Old Style. Anyways, established 1902, Old Style. Got some really great art on here. I'll be honest, it says established 1902, but the art looks very 15th century. Looks like some dark age monk shit going on there. Stuck in the caves, reading old scrolls, let's get drunk. Now they call it the dark ages, but the monks were actually hard at work trying to save and categorize civilization, so cheers to them. When I think of hard work, I definitely think of Chicago. Bootlegging that liquor from Canada. This is not bootlegged, obviously this is legal. Although it says established 1902, so there may have been some questionable years in there. Maybe Mr. Al Capone greasing some tracks for Old Style to keep its doors open. I'm not accusing Old Style of anything untowards or illegal. Anyways, love the artwork, and I am so excited to try this out. Let's crack it open. Feel like I'm rubbing elbows with some medieval monk in the German Alps, or hanging out at some baseball stadium. Has an old world feel. They did some renovations, but it's still very old, and you need your tetanus shot before you go. A little bit of vibes of being in the alleyway and back, you know, relieving yourself. Not a great thing to do, but you know, people do it. Better do it in your pants, like the jokers in St. Louis do, am I right? How do you like my accent? I've been working on it all morning, you know? Deep dish. It's pretty bad, I know. I don't feel good about myself. Anyways, back to the beer. Old Style, it's very comforting, you know, like a paternal grandfather. Let's kick back with this Chicago classic and take a sip. That is nice. As it says on the can, old world methods, choicest hops, sparkling pure spring water makes a classic lager. I agree with all those, and I'm not just saying that because they paid me, because they haven't paid me yet. So, payment on delivery, as they say. As they say in Chicago, pay me once, shame on you. Pay me twice, shame on me. I'm not entirely sure if they say that or not, but hopefully I've started a Chicago trend. Speaking of trends, this brings up another trend, the famous Chicago-style hot dog. And Old Style has found a way to make it even better, way to make it more true to Chicago's essence. And how do they do that? By boiling the hot dog in Old Style premium lager. Putting that Old Style in the pot, and some for me. Now while that beer is boiling, we're gonna start prepping the rest of the dog. And what is our hot dog of choice today? Vienna beef hot dogs, of course, to make a wonderful Chicago-style hot dog. All right, while that hot dog is cooking in the beer, we'll get the rest of it prepped. And I do have experience cooking with alcohol. Normally I'm using a nice Pinot Grigio to make some chicken piccata, or you know, Barolo wine, like Oso Buco. But we're doing beer and Franks today. It's bringing back some really great memories making the Chicago dog. Going to the baseball game. I never went. Dad took Chadwick all the time. But Chadwick would always regale me with the fun time he had at the game. And I am told that you don't want to dice these, you just want to chop them. So here we go. A nice rough chop so that these onions can really have some bite on that hot dog. And I'm told also that the tomato needs to be done in wedges. So we'll just kind of cut out a little wedge, like that. And this, I can enjoy later. It's been a while since I've been to Chicago, and they do have some wonderful restaurants there, some really top-tier restaurants I got to visit in a former life. I think if I visited Chicago now, I'd be drinking more Old Style and eating more hot dogs than visiting three-star restaurants. And that's cool too, because that's a Chicago experience. Did you know that it's not called the Windy City because of the wind, but because the politicians blow hot air? History lesson for you. Yeah. All politicians are psychopaths. Except for Chicago, where they're great. You don't hear any corruption stories coming out of that city or state, do you? You do? Well, I don't subscribe to Apple News. So it looks like the hot dogs are ready. Smelling that Vienna or the Frank, not sure which. We're gonna throw on some sweet relish first. Boop. Gonna go with this spear pickle next. That is thick. I wanna be able to taste the Vienna beef and the old style, I'm sure, which has been infused into the dog. All right, some onions, tomatoes, and the tomatoes right on top. We don't do ketchup on our Chicago dogs, so we use the coup de gras, the piece de resistance, the raison d'etre. Classic yellow mustard. Oh, is this new?
Yep,
it is sealed. Not really used to sealed new items, usually scrounging around. It's nice to not have to check the expiration date of this mustard. And I really hope they come through with this payment because I am out. I am in the red so far on this production. Brand new mustard, you know, doesn't grow on trees. Also, fun fact, Dalton doesn't know how to listen and didn't get me any sports peppers to put on this. So normally, that's what I would do. That's what real Chicagoans do. But I'm not doing it today because Dalton is a dipshit. And last but not least, the celery salt. Well, we're gonna have to do with that as well. All right, here we go, Chicago. Mmm, as good as I remember Chad explaining them to me. Mmm. Ah, wow. I am truly in nirvana. I'm getting a lot of nice classic lager, warm and salty, mixed with this hot dog. It's fantastic. Let's give it another bite. Mmm, just an explosion of flavor. The raw onion, the mellow sweetness of the tomato, the mustard kicking in, and then of course that wonderful, rich Vienna beef hot dog flavor. I feel like I'm fourth place in the Central Division. 8.5 games back. It's only May and we're already 8.5 games back. We'll bounce back. I'm really enjoying it. Mmm. That is a classic style hot dog. I got a new addiction. I mean, the great thing about hot dogs, they're fully cooked. Sometimes I don't have a gas range or a home to cook it in. So just dipping that hot dog in my beer can, that's good living. Or you put the hot dog, marinate it in that beer overnight, really let it infuse all those flavors together.
Yeah,
that's nice. Dalton, you can stop looking for the celery salt, buddy. Making a lot of noise. This is a sponsored episode, so we want to make sure the quality's high. Not sure why banging metal is involved with you looking for celery salt, but I'm almost done with the hot dog, so. I'm a little bit of a glizzy expert myself. It's a term people are using for hot dogs. So, and I'm on that train. That's the Windy City for you. I'm on the L train, the brown line downtown. Is it the red line? I don't know.
A one-armed man killed my wife.
I don't care. That was a good movie. Based in Chicago. Remember on the subway, they heard it? That's where they put him?
L line station.
They don't make movies like that anymore. Well, for my rating, I have two products to rate today, the beer and the hot dogs. And I gotta say, I was delighted with both. With its classic lager appeal, Old Style is a perfect drink heading into this wonderful summer ahead of us. And if you're wanting to throw some hot dogs on the grill to accompany that lager, well, Vienna Beef is the hot dog of choice. For my rating, I'm giving Old Style Classic Lager an 84 in honor of 1984, the year that team really got close to the big games. They didn't quite make it. But remember, this is a sponsored ad, so they get one extra point for 85, the year another Chicago team did pretty well. I can say big game. I can say superb owl. Come at me, legal teams. Come at me. And my rating for the old Chicago-style dog, I'm giving it a 91. The flavors exploded in my mouth, taking me on an oral journey through Chi-Town. And you might be saying to yourself, wait a second there, Prescott. You're wasting a bunch of old style lager in that pot behind you. Fret not, my dears. I will be using that in an upcoming episode when I make a handshake. That's right, Chicago style drink with Old Style and Malört. And boy, am I lucky to use some hot dog infused Old Style together with Malört. So stick around, like and subscribe, #OldChicagoStyleDog. Dalton,